Good morning. Welcome to IIT. So this is my project that I want to work on. I am from Drupal development team. I am working on IIT BX platform that is built on Drupal. Not entire, just the front end. So now you know, nowadays everyone is creating content. Okay, you people are sharing content on social media. But the content means there are specific content creators who are creating educational content, correct? And what's their motivation? Can anyone tell me why they create educational content? You see lots of content on YouTube, on SlideShare, okay, on a spoken tutorial website, on IIT Bombay X. You have seen the content, educational content. What's the motivation behind them? Why they are creating content? Yeah, please, louder. Any clue why? Spreading knowledge, okay. Anything else? Are they getting paid? No, who says? Many of them are not getting paid. Many of them. The huge number means the maximum number of educational content creators are not getting paid. They just create content because they like to create content. They want to contribute to the society. But there are some problems, okay. So as we know that they are self-motivated. That is a good thing. But what does the platform give them? So let's talk about YouTube. Okay, so if I am an educational content creator, what motivates me to create more content? Feedback? Likes? If I see 80% dislikes on my content, what does it mean? It demotivates me, correct? But what if that feedback also tells me where's the chance to improve yourself? That will make more sense rather than simple dislike. Dislike doesn't tell me anything, where I'm going wrong. I want to contribute to the society, I'm sharing my knowledge for free. Still I'm getting dislikes, why? Where to improve? I don't know. So what I'll do? I'll leave the system. I'll stop creating content. This is the problem. Correct? Now you understand the problem. Let's formalize it so that we can work on it. So what do you think about this equation? Do you think that learning is equal to likes? So if my content has 80% likes and 20% dislikes, that means 80% students learn from my content? So how many of you agree on this? Can you please raise your hand? One says that likes means learning. Others, please raise your hand if you are not agree with this equation. Please. Okay, good. So it doesn't tell me anything, correct? Similarly, what do you think about this equation? Do you think that if you have disliked a certain, let's say, SlideShare content or video content or whatever, does it mean that you didn't learn from it? No. You might have learned something. You might not like the presentation style, you might not like the accent that the instructor is using, or there may be many reasons. But think from the perspective of an instructor. What does he assume from your dislike? Stop creating content because students are not learning, or keep creating content in the same way because students are liking the content? Doesn't make any sense, correct? So let's create a feedback system, a good feedback system that makes some sense for the instructor as well as for the student. So this we have discussed, okay? So an educational content creator got 85% likes and 15% dislikes on the content. Is there any chance to improve the content? Teacher don't know, correct? Similarly, what to improve? No clue, no idea, correct? Let's talk about the meaningful feedback. What I am talking about, what I want to create. I want to create a meaningful feedback system rather than simply likes or dislikes. So from the research we have found, not we, some other authors have found, that the content, a student may dislike content because although the content is useful for him or her, it's mapping to the learning objective of the curriculum, but still, it's not matching with the cognitive level of the student. That means a student find it difficult. That's why I simply disliked the content, although the content is useful to him or her and he or she is learning from it. Correct? But if you say that at the cognitive level, the content is difficult to me, that tells the instructor that that means I need to work on to make it more student friendly, make it more easy. The content will remain same, presentation might be different, but now teacher knows where to improve. Okay. So let's say this is the feedback then. Previously it was only 85% likes and 15% dislike, but this time it is, let us say, effective feedback is 10% student find it boring, 60% student find it confusing, and 30% find it engaging. What does it mean as an instructor? As an instructor, I clearly see the chances where I need to improve, and I need to improve in the element. I need to find out the confusing element in my content. Correct? So I'll go through the script, I'll go through the videos, I'll try to find out the portions where student is finding it confusing, and then try to resolve there. It's making more sense than simple likes and dislikes. Okay, because I see the chance to improve the content. Okay. Similarly, if we say about cognitive feedback, 80% student find it difficult and 20% find it easy. What does it mean? I need to work on making it more easy for my student. And similarly, let us say you voted on a difficult. So you say that the content is difficult. So it is possible that you are saying it is difficult because you do not know about the prerequisites. If you know about the prerequisites, the content might be easy for you. The system should tell a student that because you find it difficult, that means you need to see this content before you are watching this or learning from this material. Okay. So this feedback will make sense for the teachers as well as for the students. So I, along with my team, would like to develop the system. Okay. And what do we need to know in order to develop the system? So we want to make it platform independent. That's the first requirement. So I want it to be used everywhere. So IIT Bombay X is already delivering the content to you. Spoken Tutorial project is running here. Sunbird, we are now trying to use it. And there are many other platforms. Okay, let us say you create your own website. IIT Bombay X teachers, so IIT Bombay teachers has their own systems where they take classes. They should be able to implement this system on their content. That is why I want it system independent. So it will be a service, SaaS model, software as a service model. We will build it separately and student and teachers will be able to get the visits for the form and then they will embed it in their content. I also want to make it independent for our teacher to create customizable form. So our system will have some standard form like the one I have talked about. This is coming from one research paper. There will be many research paper who's talking about good feedback systems. So we will try to make some standard form, let us say 4 or 5 forms we will create that a teacher can directly use on their platforms. But we will also like to provide the facility to make custom forms. So a teacher will be able to make customized form. So for example, let us say, let's talk about the IoT systems, okay, Internet of Things system, you heard about it. So IoT's lectures will be like, you will be creating something. Correct. It will be not, you can't measure it at the difficulty level, or you can't say that it is boring or engaging. The parameters to test that particular content will be different. For example, as a content creator, I would like to know whether you have tried to build it or not. So you might answer that yeah, no, maybe and yes. So if you are saying no, I'll assume that the content is not motivating you enough so that you build it. So I'll try to minimize the steps. I will try to make an easy system first, then bring the hard system into picture. Then you will be able to create it. I would like to see every student try to build it. Okay. Similarly, if you say that you have made it successfully, yes or no, okay, it is useful for both teachers as well as students, because teacher will now know if 80% student says no, that means teacher will say, okay, I need to improve the design, or I need to provide more support. For example, the coding should be provided or circuit diagram should be provided to you. Some more things will be needed to make the system. Or if you are looking at a content and you say and you see at the bottom that 80% student try to build it but were not succeeded, you immediately know that whether you will create the system or not, correct? So it will save a lot of time for the student as well. So we will try to do both. We will provide predefined forms as well as we will also provide the mechanism to create their own customizable forms. And this is the most important thing, the analytics. So without the analytics, this system is a waste. There is no point in creating the system without the analysis. So analysis will be presented at our platform, not on some other platform, because it is a software as a service kind of thing. So the whole code will be at our server. So graphs and whatever they want to see will be available on our server. If time permits, we would also like to provide a simple iframe where the result rendered there, the simplest in the simplest form, like percentage wise or pie chart, rendered in the same frame where they have put the iframe. And what do you want to know in order to create the system? We are working on, so first of all, we would like to integrate it with the spoken tutorial. That's our priority first. So a spoken tutorial is built on Drupal. Okay, so that is why I would like to create it using MySQL and PHP. Obviously, JavaScript, HTML, CSS is required for front end. Then we will also try to create modules for Drupal so that it can be integrated into any Drupal website. If time permits, we will also try to figure out if we can create plugins for Sunbirds and WordPress or not. Okay. Similarly, for the charts library, you need to know D3 or HiCharts library. There are many other libraries also. There is no fixed thing. So if some of you are not familiar with PHP MySQL, I am also happy in working with Django framework using Python language. I have no problem with that. Okay. And we would need 3 people in order to work on this project. This is email address of my group. If you have any problem, you can email me and I'll happy to resolve any of your query. Okay, thank you.